get ready.
How are we ever going to do a million things in one afternoon?
Mom, what do we do first?
Job is to read Mom's chores from Mommy's list and come and tell us what they are. You have a lot of work in the garden to do. Dad, did you finish baking the beans?
Yep, and I made sure they're well done.
Remember every time Aunt Ava gets mad, she shoots spikes at you? You better do a good job and make sure everything is perfect.
Yes, Dad. Try to follow Mom's directions exactly like she says. I don't think I have time to fix all your mistakes.
Do you remember last time Aunt Ava got mad at you?
I certainly do.
Two of the cats caught a bug, so they won't be coming.
I wonder what bug they caught.
Yeah, maybe a beetle or a wasp.
They could leave it at home or even bring it in a jar. I wouldn't mind that.
Me neither. I think bugs are cool.
Anyway, Mom wants you to remove this wasp from this tablecloth and then run an iron over it.
Okay. Okay, son. Hand me those scissors while you run and get me an iron. And I need you and Fred. I haven't finished sowing those seeds yet.
Sure thing, Dad. What's Dad doing now? Oh, he's running an iron.
wedding shower? You call this old tablecloth and chopped up flowers proper party decorations? And you're serving the guests frosted fish? Ugh!
Oh no, I think she's gonna blow!
Watch out for spikes!
Sorry I'm late, I had trouble with the hose.
When I come to visit you all, I will have great stories to tell for years and years.
Oh, and I almost forgot your gift. Someone told me you were going to tie the knot.
I don't get it. What's so funny?
Vacation and you want to go home already? There'll still be 2 more days of driving and 2 more nights of camping before we can reach the Grand Canyon. You might not want to go home once you get used to the great outdoors. Anyway, where'd Ash should go?
I'm here.
I don't want to be here, but
I think I'm the only teenager in the whole campground. Not that it matters. Even if there were kids here my age, they would probably run screaming just like the kids do back home.
Don't give up. You'll find a friend someday. I just know it. You should appreciate the time you can spend with your parents. Me and Janeth lost our parents by the time we were your age. I really wish they could come with us on this trip.
I really miss them.
Great! I made it worse!
I know, you're right. I just can't stop feeling lonely.
Why don't you gather some sticks for our campfire? It's hard to feel lonely when you're busy. We'll make s'mores under the moonlight tonight.
Okay.
How delicious! A juicy young one. I wonder if there are more like her. I could boil them and can them all for winter.
Zibi, do you see what I see? A ponchla is stalking some fresh prey, and we can't help that young girl, can we? She can't see us, can she? She can't hear us, can she? We won't outgrow our curse for 5 more years, will we? But we aren't just going to sit here and let that evil ponchla eat that child, are we? Can you think of anything we can do? I'm tired of being a helpless forest creature, aren't you?
Under another circumstance, I would love to stop and chat, but I'm quite preoccupied at the moment.
I know. That's why I'm here, to stop you.
Oh, you are delightful. But with things he could throw at me. Oh, that's rich. You forgot. You have no power over me.
I'm still not going to allow you to eat that family.
Well, there's not much you can do about this situation. The creatures you want to protect are not forest folk, so they can't see or hear in daylight. Step aside.
I've been developing some secret skills while you've spent your time spinning around in circles. I can feed my thoughts to other minds now. I know I'm not strong enough to control a witch's mind yet, but you may be surprised that I know that that's not the only way to defeat your evil.
You step aside.
Oh, really? I don't have time for this nonsense.
My parents. You should meet them. They're on her somewhere.
Hurry, she wants to eat you.
Wait for me. I just want to talk to you. I get so lonely out here without any friends.
You should move to the city then.
I've tried that, but people think I'm odd.
I know exactly what you mean. People went screaming when they see my face. I never get a chance to talk to them or even make friends.
People liked me at first, but then they went screaming when they found out about my diet.
What's so strange about your diet?
Well, I eat people.
You don't have to, do you? There's so many other things to eat. Have you ever tried s'mores? They're so delicious. At least you can control what you eat. I can't control what my face looks like. I'm gathering these sticks to cook s'mores with my family tonight. Why don't you come with me and try some?
Okay.
Dad, I made a friend. She's never eaten a s'more.
A friend? How wonderful. Let's get the s'mores ready.
Wear in a Chicago overcoat, if you know what I mean. We have 24 hours before we get the bums rushed, so we can't beat our gums all day. You can see me, but nobody else can. Now don't be a stool pigeon, because the coppers won't think you're on the up and up. Just do what I say, and everything will be hunky-dory.
But why'd you pick me? I should give you the 23 skidoo.
I don't think you're on the level.
In fact, I think you're full of baloney.
I've been scooping up clues and found that you were a canary at a clip joint singing with the coolest bands. So I found out you used to be a gold digger acting all hotsy-totsy with a fellow and then would bleed him of all his scratch.
I only hit the hi-hats and they aren't coming. Besides, I'm done with being greedy.
That's why I'm here. You're the perfect dame to double-cross a couple of goons and their dolls and save an Egyptian treasure from a museum heist. Oh, I just need you to put on the Ritz and go to your usual club.
Hey, Millie, be a doll and put on my favorite platter. These cats have got to swing.
Jay, what a swell idea. Let's get this place hopping.
Scatman!
Scooby-Doo-Badoo-Doo-Badoo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo-Doo Golly gosh, I'm so glad those trigger men didn't bump you up and take all your dough.
Ah, horseshoers. They never even got close. Whoever told you that is all wet.
Yeah, we know when to scram. Those guys on hand is for the big hats, and that's no good.
I saw that flat foot slap on those braces with my own peepers. A couple of those fellas ended up in a meat wagon.
Oh, you boys worry me so. I will always stick up for you no matter what the hep cats say. Those scoundrels get the heebie-jeebies anyways.
I wouldn't give a pluck nickel for any of them. Those lightweights would snitch on you as soon as they look at you. At least you aces know when to keep your trap shut.
Well, doesn't this look like a swell meeting?
Be a pally and bring me a cup of dog soup.
I remember her always gumming the works.
Don't be a wet blanket! That's malarkey!
We got plenty of room for another swanky cat.
Thank you! You're the bee's knees. I haven't seen you night owls in a while. I might just have a seat and catch up.
What's this heater for?
I'm packing heat for some insurance to take to our box shop tomorrow, but I'm sure I won't need it. This heist should be deck soup.
And how? I've been planning this ever since I heard about those archaeologists bringing the sacred cat statues to the museum. This job will be a piece of cake. Ooh.
Well, that does sound like a cat's meow.
And how we should be sitting pretty after we get that dough from that butter and egg man.
Oh, he's not getting his meat hook from those cats. Let's stay at my paws. Those cats are going to my cave.
Hey! What kind of plump jump do you take me for? You're going to boondoggle me out of my cut! Load up your duke! I'm going to land you on your case, sir!
Don't blow your wig! I'm the one with the safe-cracking skills. I always leave a clean sneak.
Let's blow this joint.
Those live wires are going to get us pinched. We better go shake a leg.
And how? Gee, girls, it's been the snakes that seen you again. And I got someplace else to be. Don't take any wooden nickels. Aren't you a good egg, meeting me here? I tried to get you on the horn, but I'm such a sap. I didn't even get your number.
Oh, you kid, I was tailing you the whole time. Good thing you flew the coop before the squad car rolled in. You should stay on the land while the gumshoes tighten the screws on those grifters. Your pips might sing in a squeeze and make you take the rap with them. Those heels don't play on the level.
Oh, applesauce. I got my glad rags on and I got all dolled up for nothing. At least I know when I take a powder before it all goes bananas. You're a real good egg, even if the original plans got scrambled. The important thing is, you are safe and the statues are safe. Well, if that don't beat all.
Choices. Plus, we get to show some great gymnastic skills. Like
Like Lexi said, this is very entertaining.
We trained for months to get the scenes just right without Shakespeare.
Let's take a look at one of the scenes you're talking about. Lexi, is there anything you want the audience to know before we show this clip?
In this scene, we have just found out the snakes are behind the disappearance of hundreds of hamsters. But right now, we're in the middle of a gymnastics competition.
We know we have to compete and we don't want to lose our focus. As soon as the contest ends, we will set off and defeat all the evil snakes.
You have to go see the movie to find out how we can all save hamsters for many future generations.
Let's do just that. But for now, here's Lexi and Skytra and Scurrying Slither. All over their bodies.
And if that's not enough to scare off a predator,
Many pufferfish are extremely toxic. They produce a chemical that's 100 times more powerful than cyanide and could kill an animal or person in minutes. There's one kind of pufferfish that has enough toxin in its liver to kill up to 30 people. That makes them right behind the poison dart frogs for the most poisonous creatures on Earth. Looks can be deceiving, but these cute little guys are actually deadlier than sharks.
Show for my protection, and my antlers are very helpful in a fight.
We have a challenge set up where you get to use your antlers in a contest of wit and speed. But first, let's meet your opponent, Red Bull. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
What do you want to know?
Well, for starters, how do you use your horns?
I also use my horns in self-protection. Big, scary beasts try to mess with me. Soon they'll learn that looks can be deceiving.
I'm smaller than my opponents, but I haven't lost the battle yet.
That's good, because we have to remind our audience that if you lose this contest, you will be turned into a carrot. I bet we're all curious how that'll look.
No way, not going to happen.
We will have to see about that. I usually fight pirates that are a lot scarier than you. Besides, just because I like to eat carrots doesn't mean I want to be one. I'm going home with that 24-carat gold prize.
To win this game, you have to be the first person to completely use every streamer in this barrel to rub a tree.
To complicate matters, our next two contestants will try to get in your way. Everyone, meet Waspworm, the woodland wasp scorpion, and Bob, our studio tree spirit. On your mark, get set, go!
This next contest. Bob, you go first.
I think the audience and the world should know that I have dedicated my life to protecting and preserving trees. Trees provide food, beauty, shelter, and homes for animals. You might want to know that my opponent here spends his time stealing children.
I don't just steal children. I do a lot of helpful things too. I eat caterpillars to destroy crops and garden vegetables. Sometimes I feed the carcasses of dead insects to my children. They eat those things up and clean the world of piles and piles of dead insects. On the scorpion side of things, my venom is used to treat heart disease and cancer.
Interesting. We have another contestant who likes to scare children. Meet Spider-Man. No, not from the comics, just a hero for spiders.
That's right. I've spent my life rescuing spiders from untimely deaths to the hands of cruel children. Silk from spiders may also be used in the future for things like bridges and bulletproof clothing because how flexible they are, but also stronger than steel.
Let's see who's the strongest in our wildest beast obstacles. But first, we have one more player to introduce. Meet Snuppy. Thank you for taking the time off your usual business of tripping villagers with your silly but snake-like moves.
Oh, I'm going to make this contest much more interesting. I'm the only half-snake, half-puppy on Earth. This is my first visit outside of my village, so very few people know about me.
Whoa, you're going to make me feel sad when I have to turn the last Snuppy on Earth into a carrot. Do you have someone go over the contract before you signed it?
Yep, that's no problem, because I'm going to win. I made sure that the contract didn't prevent me from tripping other players. So we'll see how this goes.
I'm feeling a little better about the possibility of turning into a carrot. But now, it's time for all the players to get in their starting positions.
On your mark, get set, go!
Thank you.
Action. Line action.
I know.
Okay, go ahead.
I know. Ow.
Action.
Now you see where my femur is just
I saw that flat foot slap on those bracelets with my own peepers. A couple of those ended up in a meat wagon.
Oh boy.
This is happening.
Can you think of anything we can do? I'm tired of being a helpless forest creature, aren't you? Yes.
Action. No.
Oh, dang it.
Action.
We have an amazing assortment of talented treasures.
Action.
We have one champion and four carrots for lunch. What are you having for lunch?
I thought it was five.
Yes, it's five.
We have one champion and four...
Five. Oh, Jesus. And action. Chucky.
Put up your suits. I'm ready to go on your keister.
Don't blow your wig! I'm the one with the safe crack and skills. Oh dear, me again.
Hey, Jonah, maybe like here are her arms on so you can follow her.
Caleb, go ahead and play. Two, one, action. Wrong way.
You can't go.
That should be. Okay. Darn it. Okay. Could I just set one down and then do it?
Yes.
Did you know Frog and Fox in some
junior?
Just do what I say and everything will be hunky-dory.
Oh!